start with your front parts. You mainly washed it, right, today? Are you allergic to anything? Okay. I do have here some products that I would really like to try on your scalp and hair. Is there a certain way that you style it usually?
Just down.
Okay. And do you like the parts in the front a little bit shorter, right, than the rest of the hair?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So you do have beautiful, natural, curly hair. We can definitely see how we can style it and treat it in the same time. I'm going to start with a hydrating mist. And I'm going to apply mostly towards the end. I'm not going to apply a lot. When was the last time you had a haircut?
About 6 months, probably.
Okay. And how often do you like to cut it?
I don't get it cut very often.
Okay.
I should, definitely.
Well, it does look well hydrated. And is that you're taking good care of it?
Yeah, everything curly here is just very expensive.
Okay. I want to see how the natural curly hair goes down, and we're gonna try probably to increase some of the volume on each curl individually. Mm-hmm. That will definitely bring some definition. I'm going to apply curl air dry cream. It's sulfate free. I'm going to apply just a little bit. trying. Making sure that we are increasing the natural curl. And how often do you usually wash your hair?
I wash my hair every day.
Every day?
I just don't shampoo it every day.
Okay.
I only use shampoo like twice a week.
Okay. Yeah, it definitely protects the scalp and allows for the hair to grow longer, faster. Making sure that we keep the nutrients in. And this is your natural color, right?
Yes.
Yeah, this cream definitely protects from any outside pollution or anything that might be in the air. Going to use some of the hair that's under to create that volume. I'm going right under the curl as it starts to twist. That usually helps. gently. And is there any way that you would like to maybe style it today?
You can style it however you want.
Okay. Alright, I love the freedom. I would say that we need to take advantage of how beautifully proportioned your face is. So, something that really would accentuate the color of your eyes. Bringing here a tiny bit, maybe, behind. Going to apply contouring gel. It's going to be very light. It has coconut water, so also it's hydrating. And we're just going to apply it on each curl individually. And as you can tell, there's more volume to the whole curl. And I like to do that a lot in the front, just to, because this is the first part that we see. And then I will focus on the back as well. I'm just gonna maybe try to see if we can bring some volume here without damaging the curls. Going to apply some molding paste, just a tiny bit, and I'm going to focus on the overall aspect. I have argan oil. It's definitely going to help to keep some of that moisture in. Not applying a lot. And we're just going to focus mainly on helps to reduce some of that frizz. I'm going to apply scalp and root treatment. It helps to restore some of the thickness to the hair, and it has green coffee oils, so it's going to revitalize. Am I supposed to put it on the scalp directly?
You can drop it on the scalp directly, or you can put it on your hands and then put it on.
Okay.
But some people will like put it and drop it on the scalp directly.
Yeah, maybe I should do that.
Good.
Okay. I'm going to apply some oils. It helps to make the hair a little bit thicker and fuller. So it's a scalp treatment. I'm going to apply some usually on this side of your scalp. I like to make sure that it goes really well into the scalp. And I did notice that the hair follicle is a little bit thinner on this side. Going to massage it, and this is a leave-in treatment, so you can definitely just let it air dry. You can wash it tomorrow. Apply some at the base of your scalp. I'm going to apply eye mask, and then we're going to just apply a little bit of makeup, make sure that we are ready. going to do something very simple, something that would just accentuate your eyes, your natural features. So I'm going to have you close your eyes. This eye mask is going to help to debuff, hydrate, and also regenerate the sensitive skin that we have under our eyes. I'm going to leave this for about 15 minutes. In the meanwhile, I did notice that the skin around your neck is a little bit dry as well. So I'm going to use this product to apply hydration. To focus on the neck lines. Doesn't really smell, so I really like that. Okay, I'm going to go ahead and remove the eye mask. Increased hydration. I'm not seeing any redness, so there was no reaction with the natural skin. Okay. I'm going to apply some concealer, just a little bit to decrease some of the perfect, just look up. I'm not going to apply a lot. Okay, blending it naturally. Okay. going to apply some lamination wax on your brows just to give them some definition. Okay, go ahead and close your eyes. So we're starting inward and moving up. Just going along the natural line of your eyebrows. This doesn't have any color, it just uses the natural color of your hair. I think I am noticing that one eyebrow is a little bit thicker than the other one, but that definitely can be corrected with some color. And I'm going to apply some eyeshadow. So this is just a crayon eyeshadow. It's very pasty and I really like that it will blend it with your natural colors, especially of the hair. So I'm going to apply a little bit at the base just to give that shine. And is it okay if I apply some lip gloss and a little bit of crayon?
Sure.
Okay. So we're just going to contour, go on the natural. I am already, so I'm gonna go ahead and use this. Go ahead and relax your lips just a little bit.